So I did write a speech. I'm actually going to read off of it because I don't want to screw it up. No, no, you can't because it's about you. Sorry, it's face ID. Okay. Literally. Oh my God. I've done well without the notes. Okay. So you're my bride, but you're really my best mate. I feel like I'm stealing the show, standing up here and thanking everyone, because really you deserve the stage yourself.
Ain't no surprise that I can't sleep tonight. My only vice is standing by your side. So won't you love me better? I'm waiting here. I need you now. Gravity can't hold us down. So just take me there.
Friends of Pete and Marcel, welcome and thank you for joining us on this special day. I understand that you have all traveled from near and far to be here today and witness the shared love of this beautiful couple, to offer your love and support to this union and to allow Pete and Marcel to start their married life together, surrounded by the people dearest and most important to them.
I promise to always work on our love, and that when things become difficult, I promise not to run, but to communicate with you in respect. Now, that is a loaded sentence.
Okay, so this is funny. Pete, we seem to have this running joke that I always seem to have all the luck. That someone up there is always looking out for me. I always get the best parking space. I usually win at bingo. The sun always shines when I need it to. Things always fall into place when I need them to. But of all the things, that luck has brought me through the years, the luckiest thing life has brought me is you. The love of my life, my best friend, the person that makes me a better person, the person who understands me more than I think I understand myself. There are so many things I admire about you. You live your life humbly because that's the way you were raised. And I know you'll be an amazing father one day. I love you for so many these reasons and so many more.
Marriage is perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure of any human relationship. To make this relationship work takes more than just love. It takes trust to know in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It takes dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow, even when it's difficult to do so. It takes time, effort, courage and commitment. And it takes faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds for you both. May the stormy days you encounter only ever make you both stronger. Today, you lay the foundation of your future, life together, cemented with love, trust, laughter, strength, and unity.
Thank you. Yeah.
You decided to wear that.
Of course. I love
it. We all went to high school together with Marisol, and so we had the blessing to grow up with Marisol. And you know, Marisol has proven herself to be nothing more than the absolute most dedicated friend anybody could ever ask for. And as we go through life, is that not what we all want, is a friend?
I've always told you that luck follows you around in life. But today, it's me who feels like the luckiest man alive. You look absolutely stunning, standing in front of me, and you've once again taken my breath away. The love that everyone here and across the world has for you is a testament to the woman I've asked to spend the rest of my life with. 6 years ago, I found you in Australia, and I've been so blessed to hold your hand through those subsequent years. We've been through many experiences together, creating some incredible memories, as well as battling through some tougher times. And it's been through those same experiences that I also discovered the reasons why I fell in love with you. You definitely bring to my life a different level of energy that I didn't realize I needed. So much joy I did not know I was lacking, and a new perspective on life I couldn't see before. You see something in me that I don't often see in myself. And reflecting back on these last 6 years, since the day I met you, it was really you who took my hand and made me the better man. You're the most beautiful, smart, creative, and generous person I've ever known. And I promise I'll do my very best to not let you down. I want nothing more than to ensure you remain the same wonderful woman that everyone loves. You really do deserve the world, and you can count on me with the utmost loyalty, trust, and respect to work by your side to create a wonderful life together. And whilst I've said a few things to you today in words, it's really hard to put down in words to tell you how much I love you, so I want my actions to speak for themselves for the rest of our lives together.
I made a very bold statement to you. I told you that no one would ever love you like I would love you. Do you remember that?
I do remember that. Creepy.
Little did I know that one day, today, I would be standing here in front of our friends and family and turning that statement into a promise. Pete, I do promise that no one will ever love you the way I love you. I promise to love you and in good times and in bad, even when you've had a bad night of sleep. I promise to always work on our love, and that when things become difficult, I promise not to run, but to communicate to you in respect. I promise to push you and challenge you to drive towards your dreams. I promise to never stop laughing and be silly with you. I promise to always encourage you to play your guitar because I know it brings you joy and creativity. Pete, you make me feel more loved than I ever thought possible, and I promise to spend the rest of my days making you feel the same. I love you.
Oh, it smells great. What is it?
That's your spice.
Did you get it?
Yeah, I got it.
So if you don't know by now, our loves, if you don't know by now, that's incredible, but Marisol and I met in Australia 6 years ago. Sandy beaches. And then we took a plane back to the UK 3 years ago, 2018. And if you're following Marisol's adventures in the UK, you knew she really enjoyed it. She loved the UK, yeah? Yeah? Those weren't tears of happiness. She didn't want to leave. She did never want us to leave. She, with the British weather, it's unpredictable. It rains a lot. So much so that in order to avoid rain for me and her, we've ended up in the Mojave Desert, Las Vegas. And I like to think we've stopped moving. Yeah. But the fellow Americans here have all promised me over 120 degrees Fahrenheit desert heat, or 45 degrees centigrade desert heat on the way back and in a couple of months. So I don't think we've finished moving. At the same time, this wedding's been delayed 3.5 years. 3.5 years. So it's been a long time coming, and obviously last 2 years have been really tough for everybody. I want to acknowledge that. But also life seems to have a way of moving on.
About a decade ago in 2012, when I was blessed with the opportunity to move from Las Vegas to Singapore, the first person that I asked whether or not I should, you know, take a leap of faith, jump, move, just pack two bags, knowing nobody else in a foreign destination, she was the most supportive person I had in my corner. She said, yes, don't think twice, by all means, go do it, explore the world. And I feel so lucky because, you know, I had the opportunity to reciprocate that same advice to Marisol. So I was in Singapore for 1 year, in 2012 to 2013, or sorry, 2011 to 2012. And then when I came back to Las Vegas, Marisol was faced with a very similar opportunity. She said, Air, I got this job with LinkedIn, and it's gonna take me halfway across the world, 16-hour time difference. Did I get that right? 16 hours? More or less. Yeah, you don't know? 16-hour time difference. Should I do it? And I said, Marisol, you already know what I'm gonna say. You pack those bags, you go, you take that leap of faith. And I feel so lucky to have done that because, you know what? As you referenced, Pete, it was not even 6 years ago when you and Marisol finally decided to attack life together. And she said, Air. She looked at myself and my wife. She said, Air, I don't know what to do. I have this dilemma because there's this one person that I don't necessarily want to ruin a friendship over, but I know there's something more there. She said, I could either do option A and just coast and stay comfortable, or I could do option B and go with somebody whom I know there is a future with. And she said, you know what, there may be one or two more hurdles before we get to that ease of relationship, but I need to know whether or not I should do it. And Courtney and I looked at each other and we said, Marisol, there is no doubt about it. You need to take that leap of faith and do what your heart feels is right. And lo and behold, here we are. After many delays, we finally get to celebrate this union.
Do you, Pete, take this woman to be your wedded wife?
I do.
Do you, Marisol, take this man to be your wedded husband?
I do.
Please, face each other and take each other's hands. These are the hands of your best friend that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it and comfort in difficult times. These are the hands that will support and encourage you to pursue your dreams. Pete, as you place the ring on Marisol's finger, please repeat after me.
With this ring,
I marry you and bind my life to yours.
I marry you and bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
It's a symbol of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
Marcel, as you place the ring on Pete's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I marry you and bind my life to yours.
I marry you and bind my life to yours.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
It is a symbol of my eternal love.
My everlasting friendship.
My everlasting friendship.
And the promise of all my tomorrows.
And the promise of all of my tomorrows.
The ring is a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. When you look at these rings on your hands, be reminded of this beautiful moment, your commitment, and the love you now feel for each other. May you always find new ways to nourish each other's lives while finding greater meaning in your own. May your home be a place of joy for all who enter it, a place for endless laughter. May you find happiness by making one another happy. May you find love by loving one another. And may you commit to the journeys that you have both pledged to each other here today. It is now my honor and pleasure to pronounce you husband and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
I swear to God, when I come home, I'm gonna hold you so close. I swear to God, when I come home, I'll never let go. Like a river I flow into the ocean I know. You pull me close, guiding me home.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm alive. Is everybody alive? All right. All right, before Marisol gets angry with me, because, you know, she always say to me, Dad, make it short. First of all, before my dementia kicks out, I want to thank everybody for coming here to celebrate the wedding of Marisol and Pete. And of course, I'd like to thank Pete's family, mom, dad, grandma, and their partners, and all their friends too. Your friends, I know some of them. There you go. But thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. And of course, Marisol's friends. There you go, beautiful ladies. Woo! And friends. Very good. Thank you all, thank you all. Okay. Well, during our younger days, we'd all do this. And first of all, me and my wife has been doing it. Can we do it? That's the disco hustle! Maestro, hit it! All right, those were my dancing days. Woo! Sometime in September of 2016, my wife and I went to Switzerland on vacation. Beautiful Switzerland, right? Anybody went to Jungfrau? Yeah. Ooh, not cold out there, freezing cold, right? Oh, but beautiful. Anyway, we started taking pictures. And Marisol wants the Swiss flag as a background. Okay, there's the flag. The Swiss flag is right there behind. And she gave her cell phone to my wife. And patiently, click, 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 and showed to Marisol. And Marisol, Mommy, it's not the right thing. You gotta take the picture when the Swiss flag is, you know, it's like spreading completely. I was like, oh my God. All right, so with her hands freezing and her butt freezing, she gave the cell phone to me. Here, let your daddy take the picture. And here I am, patiently, it's like waiting for the wind to blow and come on, Swiss flag, come on, wind, blow it, so I could take a picture of Marisol. And sure enough, patiently, the wind blows. And the flag just, and bingo! What a perfect shot. And then gave it to her. Perfect, daddy. Perfect shot. That was good. So the lesson is, that is Marisol. She always wanted the perfect one. Well, Marisol, see what you got. Pete, the handsome man, the patient man, and the loving man. Let's give them a big hand.
And so before I hand things off to the lovely groomsmen who, I mean, I'm rocking the pink, but I mean, there's one more gift I want to give to you, Pete, as I send you off. Can you do me a favor and reach underneath there? Go ahead and take that out. Go ahead and unfold that. I didn't want you to be feeling left out not wearing pink, so, you know. I just want you to feel welcomed as you take this leap of faith into this marriage with Marisol, because God knows you're gonna need it.
congratulations to you both. What an amazing day, everyone. Hasn't it been fantastic? You guys both look incredible. Now, when an excited Pete, and he was excited to finally settle on a destination wedding of Croatia, my heart immediately leapt to what I see before me today. Cool linen shirts, nice light chinos. I thought it was some sort of sick joke when he said that we stood here in a black tuxedo in 33 degree heat. People that know the real Pete Holder know that he prefers spending time alone, by himself, in his room, learning every word to 8 Mile and playing single player PS4 games. Pete still enjoys being called Pete P-Rabbit, and he loves the 8 Mile handshake, so I'm going to take the opportunity. Don't forget the click. The click is the most important bit. Moving on. So Pete has a genuine addiction to buying guitars. I don't know how many you have. It's always one more than when I last spoke to you. Apparently you have a YouTube channel where you film yourself singing and playing guitar, but you won't tell us the username. I think you know how much rinsing you're going to get for that. But I've heard you're pretty good, so that's good.
So look, to Aaron's point, I think these two are always going to end up together. And look, Marcel, I'm not sure whether Pete has actually told you this story, but when you first started dating, he convinced you that he can play the guitar to any song at the first sound of hearing it. At the time, I lived with Pete, and I can tell you he practiced that song for several weeks.
One thing I love about you is that you pour your heart and soul into everything that you do for me, but also for others. This day has been orchestrated by Marisol, and that's why I wanted to stand up, because it really has. and it's been absolutely incredible. I'm so proud of you for everything you've done. I can't wait to see where America takes us, or the rest of the world at this point. And I can ask for a better dance partner in my life. I mean, every word of my vows to you, and I can't wait to honeymoon with you in the back of this in Turkey.
Let's give a toast to Pete and Marisol. Best wishes. Best wishes to both of you, and lots of kids.
So please raise your glasses to the bride and the groom.
To many happy years of marriage together. Have you?
ask myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot. Call the police and the fireman, I'm too hot. Make a dragon wanna retire, man, I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am, I'm too hot. And my band bought that money, break it down. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Girls hit you, hallelujah. Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Cause